Praise the Lord. This is the Church of God coming to you from Trenton, Michigan. We have nothing to preach but good news, telling you about Jesus Christ.
Yes.
We trust that somebody will be saved. Everybody that's listening, we pray that's unsaved will find Jesus today, or he'll find you. We don't find him, he finds us. I'm so glad tonight that we can declare that Jesus is Lord to the glory of God the Father. So at this time, we're going to ask Brother Don to come and sing a couple of good gospel songs. I'm sure you enjoy them. Please write for them if you really enjoy the singing, and we'll send you some cassette tapes, and it'll be a blessing to play it in your car or if you go down the road. You never know. Somebody will hear it and get saved. Come on, Brother Don.
Amen.
Yes, praise God. Thank the Lord tonight. Salvation is on the Lord.
Follow instructions to put anything together. And Pastor
that's good.
Charlie preached that, and it stuck in my heart that we have got to follow him.
Amen.
And God gives me something to say to just about anyone, and I say it, it seems to touch your heart, because I know we got to live for him.
Yes.
He lived for us and he died for us.
Yes.
Amen.
And the curse of mankind was taken off. God let it come off on his son. He loved the people, and
yes.
he realized that he put that curse on there, and he didn't mean to. He wanted them to have a chance to make it. You know, we wouldn't have had no chance if it hadn't been through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I owe him my life, my soul, and my body. And I'm willing to do whatever God wants me to do. To lay down my life for anything else.
Come on.
For him.
Yes.
And I think everyone in this world should do that. I think they should open their eyes and see the man that's making it possible for us to live today.
Amen.
Through the breath of life.
Yes.
That's the life we're getting, the breath of life from Jesus.
Yes.
And Almighty God. I praise him with all my heart and soul.
That's right.
Yes.
And we got to follow them instructions like Charles preached.
Yeah.
And I realize that, and we haven't been doing that. We've been following our own.
Amen.
And not God.
But yeah, we got a hold on. Yes, sir.
I love them with all my heart and soul. I love all you people out there as much as God loves you. And I hope you make it, because we got a chance to make it now.
That's right.
And I give you all the glory of God.
Yes.
He has the glory of all. In Jesus' name, God
Amen.
Bless you all.
Thank you. Thank you, Frank. Yes. Start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my God above to be living here today.
Yes.
'Cause a flag still stands for freedom.
Yes.
And they can't take that away. Thanks.
But if you're a red-blooded American, you love it.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God. I love it so much, I joined the Army. And during wartime, too.
It was great.
And I went out to the courthouse and asked them to call me. And about 3 or 4 days later, they called me and my buddies that were with me. And we stayed together all the time through basic training. I'll never forget those days that I really wanted to give my life to the country that we live in. I would have given it. And it was a great time. I think about those days. But tonight we're thinking about the Word of God.
Amen.
Amen.
I tell you, I didn't know the Lord back then, but I knew of Him. I mean, it's just like Abraham and Lincoln. We know there was Abraham. There was an Abraham Lincoln.
Amen.
We may know of them, but we don't know them. Amen. I asked a fellow one time, a supervisor, I said, "Do you know the Lord?" He said, "No," but he said, "I don't know Him, to be honest with you, but I've heard of Him." So a lot of people have heard of Him, but they don't know Him as their personal Savior.
That's right.
Amen.
I'm so thankful tonight that He saved me many, many years ago, some 50-some years ago, when I looked up and Jesus looked down. Made a brand new creature out of me. Changed my life completely.
Yes, amen.
Put my foot on a solid foundation and said, "Boy, live for me and you'll be blessed."
Amen.
And I have. I've been blessed down through the years and I thank God for it.
Amen.
Tonight we will talk about a fellow that had to go down to the potter's house, and that was Jeremiah, the prophet. God told him to go to the potter's house and watch him work on the wheel.
Yes.
You know, the potter can take, we're the, he's the potter and we're the clay.
Yes.
And he takes us and shapes us and molds us the way he wants us.
Amen.
And I never will forget that time that he taken me when I didn't have anything, didn't know anything. I still don't know much, but I know one thing. I know in whom I believe, and I'm persuaded he's able to keep that which I've committed unto him against that day.
Amen.
Now, when the potter begins to work on the wheel, he takes those talented fingers and he shapes that vessel the way he wants it.
Amen.
Sometimes a vessel can get, now I'm applying to a person now, sometimes we are saved, but sometimes we get dirty. Sometimes we need a good rinsing by the working of the Word of God.
Yes.
And sometimes it gets broke. Sometimes you fall and you miss the mark and you have to repent and ask God to forgive you.
Amen.
And He will forgive you if you're with a sincere, honest heart. He will forgive you. And then, too, He'll take those talented fingers and just shape you in a way that, you know, that you want to go.
Amen.
Because He's God, He's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we could think or ask, according to the power of God that works in us. We got power working in us.
Amen.
I want to tell you, when I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, with the evidence, initial evidence of speaking in another tongue, I'm telling you, the power of God came in us and dwells there. And this is the temple of God. This is the place that God lives. This building, this house here, is the church is not the building.
Yeah.
It's not the house of God. Our bodies are the temple of God.
That's right.
Amen. And God dwells in us. And
Come
He
on.
Walks in us. And He talks in us. Amen. Amen. And He communes with us.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. So everybody today sometimes has to go back to the Father's house and get a rehealing.
Amen.
That's right.
Get a reworking on the wheels, you know. Just getting shaped up, you get out of shape, you
Amen.
Miss a marker, and you fall, and you come short of the glory of God.
Yes.
And I know the Old Testament says that we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. Not nobody's righteous, no, not one. We've all, like sheep, have gone astray, and the Lord has laid on Him the iniquity of us all.
Lord. Thank
I think
you,
in Isaiah 53 said, "Surely He has taken our sickness and our pain, and we did esteem Him, stricken and smitten and afflicted. He was wounded for our trespasses. He was bruised for our iniquity. And the chastisement of our peace was upon Him. And with His stripes, thank God, we are healed." Somebody say, healed. We're healed, amen.
We're healed.
Healed by the grace of God. Healed by the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen. And God don't make no junk either, I'm going to tell you that, friend. When he made you, thank God, David said, listen to what David said, I'm fearfully and wonderfully made. I tell the devil that every once in a while. I'm fearfully and I'm wonderfully made.
Yeah.
The devil's scared to death of me. He's scared. He trembles when he sees me.
Yeah.
He trembles when he sees me.
Hallelujah.
Because he knows you've got the power of God that's able to cast him out. Amen.
Amen.
And I'll tell you, I've seen some of them get casted out
Praise
in my lifetime. And I'm so glad tonight that this old time blood bought heaven salt and salvation is still real and powerful today as it was 50 some years ago when I looked up and Jesus looked down.
Yes.
Now, tonight we can get a reworshiping of the word of God. And the Bible tells us that we're new creatures in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Aren't you glad you're new? God made you anew. He's taken this whole sinful body, this sinful life, and changed it and put in taken out this whole heart of flesh and give us a heart of praise and a heart of the Spirit of God.
Come on.
That we can communicate with the Heavenly Father and talk to Him and have conversations with Him. Amen. How many glad that we can talk to God tonight. We don't have to go slipping around, amen, and trying to sneak into the kingdom of God.
Amen.
He said, you know what he said? Come boldly.
Amen.
Did he not say, come boldly through the throne of God? God, help us tonight. We don't have to slip in. Somebody said, if I could just slip in. You don't have to slip in. Just come boldly before
amen.
The presence of God.
Amen.
He'll communicate with you. He'll communicate with you.
Amen.
And he'll talk with you and he'll help you.
Yes.
Praise God. He loves you. I don't care if you're drinking a fifth of whiskey a day. He still loves you. Amen.
Yes.
He wants to save you. He wants to redeem you. He wants to put you on that revolving wheel and take those talented fingers and shape you and mold you until you become a what God wants. You know, he might put his signature on that vessel until he gets it just exactly where he wants it. Sometimes I said people can fall and get dirty. They can be rinsed out, you know. Sometimes they can backslide. Oh, you believe in backsliding? No, I don't. I believe you go to hell if you stay that way.
Yes.
But you can come back to God.
Yes.
I know he's not only the God of the first church change. He's the God of many changes. Amen.
Amen.
If people will truly repent and ask him to come into their heart and change their ways.
Amen.
He said, if my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, he said, I would hear from heaven, I would forgive their sins and heal their land. America is sick tonight. Sin sick. Now, I'm going to tell you, I've never seen America in the shape it's in tonight.
Amen.
Tell you, everywhere you look is trouble and sin, and everybody's trying to get the right candidate for the president. My friends, you listen to this preacher, there may never be another presidential election.
Amen.
You ever think about that? All this president has to do right now is establish martial law and keep on being the president of the United States of America. I don't know what's going to happen. Maybe a war with Israel. And this, they tell me it's right on the blink right now. Every person in Israel has got a weapon in their hand. They say even women carrying weapons around because they're on alert, 24-hour alert, ready for war anytime. And I'm going to tell you, there are foreign missiles in there. But I'll tell you one thing. I know who. I read the end of the results of this thing. I read the end of the book. We win. Amen. Israel is going to win too also. Thank God for the grace of God that's sufficient to meet every need according to his riches in glory. How many knows God's not poor? He's got riches that we haven't ever got in. He's got a storehouse we ain't ever got into yet.
Amen.
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 He blessed us. Thank God that we'd be the head, not the tail. In fact, he really said that Abraham's blessing is yours. He said, if you be Christ's, then you're Abraham's seeds and heirs according to the promise. So we're Abraham's seeds and we're heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. We got equal rights.
Amen.
We got equal rights tonight. And we don't even know it. But thank God I'm beginning to find out that I've got equal rights with him. And I can call upon him any time of the day or night. He's never on a journey. He's never asleep. I'm going to tell you, when Elijah mocked those men there on the Mount Calvary, where was it? Anyway, he began to mock these men. And he said, cry a little louder. Maybe he's asleep. Wake him up. Maybe he's on a journey. Cry a little louder. But when Elijah knelt to pray, he prayed a prayer of 63 words. And I'll tell you, the fire of God fell and licked up the dust and the burnt sacrifice, amen, consumed the dust and the fire, burned up everything, and amen. The people began to say, the Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God, amen. And He'll always be God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It's a great day to be alive, friend. Thank God we know that we are the generation that's going to usher in the kingdom of God. There's no doubt in my mind. Troublesome times is here, perilous times, dangerous times is here. Men's hearts are failing for fear of things that's coming upon the earth. And I'm going to tell you, we need to be right with God.
Yes.
Not be somebody's, well, I'm trying. It ain't good enough. You can be right with God. You don't have to try to be right. You can be right with Him. You can surrender your life and say, God, I'm yours. I'm yours. I gave my life to the Lord some 50-some years ago, and I said, Lord, I'm yours. I'm yours. Take me, use me, mold me, shape me, ever what I am on this altar. Take me, and amen, and get glory from it. Praise God. And He has. I'll tell you, it's a great life to live, a great Christian life.
Amen.
To know that your sins are gone before you.
Amen.
Some men's sins go before them, some men's sins follow. I don't want my sins to follow me. I want them to go before me.
Yeah.
Because
amen.
If they go before me, after me, then I'm going to be judged of them. And I'm not going to go to hell, praise God.
Amen.
Yes, hell's going to be a reality as heaven's going to be a reality.
Amen.
But thank God you don't have to go to hell. God did not prepare the hell for the devil. He prepared it for the devil and the angels and his angels. He didn't prepare the hell for you and I. He loves you. Jesus loved this world so much. God so loved this world so much that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe upon Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And that life is in His Son.
Amen.
He said, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. No man comes to the Father except through and by me. He's the door. No man can enter in. All that ever came before was thieves and robbers. But thank God. Hallelujah. When I came before Him with an open heart. I said, God, take me, mold me, shape me, put me on that revolving wheel if I make a mistake. And I've made some mistakes, and so have you. There's nobody perfect. He was the only perfect man that ever walked this earth.
Amen.
I said, praise the Lord. I know you all think you're super duper Christian, but you're not, you know. We all fail. We all come short sometimes.
Right.
But I'll tell you, He's a merciful God. Yes. David cried out to the Lord. Amen.
Yes.
He said, bless the Lord, my soul, and all that's within me. Bless His holy name. Thank God who forgiveth all my iniquity, who healeth all of my diseases. That's what David said about the Lord. Amen. Thank God tonight we got a healer. Thank God we got a miracle worker also.
Amen.
He still performs miracles, even though some of the denominations says that all passed away with the apostles. When they died off, there's no more miracles and no more healing. That's what you think, mister. I'm going to tell you, miracles are still happening. People are still getting healed. Thank God I've been healed of God. I've been healed of heart trouble, praise the Lord. And I thank God for it.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you something, friend. He's a great miracle worker also. I seen God perform a miracle on a woman one night. Had lymph cancer all through her body. And God healed her. And she went, they taken her every year, couldn't find a trace of that cancer. Thank God she lived to be 13 more years after that. So I'm so glad tonight He's a miracle worker. He's still on the throne and still has all power in heaven and earth. And He can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think. Now the Bible says according to the power of working in us.
Yeah.
We got power, Brother Charles, working in us. We got the answer of the Holy Ghost that's in us. And I'm going to tell you, God can take you and He can use you to cast out devils. You know what Jesus, the Bible says in the 16th chapter of St. Mark, He said, these signs shall follow them that believe.
Yes,
he said, in my name they'll cast out devils. In my name they'll speak with new tongues. In my name they'll take up serpents. In my name they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. And in my name they shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. That's what he said. That's what he said.
Glory.
I said he said it. And brother, when he said it, he meant it. Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Thank God he's a miracle worker. Thank God he's a great physician. Amen. He's a great physician. Praise the Lord. He's able to do what we can believe him to do.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
And you can believe him to work a wonder and a miracle, he can do it, friend.
Oh,
I'm going to tell you, this Bible, this word of God is truth.
Yes.
His word is forever settled in heaven. Heaven and earth will pass away, but this word will abide forever. He'll never change his word for nobody.
No.
It's forever settled.
Amen.
He'll not compromise as the word. And I'm not going to compromise the preaching of the word of God. I'm going to tell you, hell's real and hell is going to be hot.
Amen.
And heaven is sweet, and I'm going there. Praise the Lord. I got a made up mind. I've got my foot on that solid foundation, and I'm not looking back. I'm not going to be like Lot's wife and look back and turn to a pillar of salt.
Amen.
I'm pressing on toward the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. I got my mind made up and my foot on that solid foundation.
Thank
God that foundation is a sure foundation.
Amen.
Paul said there is no other foundation than that which is already laid, which is Christ Jesus. Amen.
Yes, amen.
So we know in whom we believe today.
Yes, amen.
And I'm certainly pleased to know that he hears my prayers and answers my prayers. Amen. Now there's sometimes we got to trust in the Lord.
Yes.
The Bible says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to your own human reasoning. You can reason God out of everything if you ain't careful.
That's right.
But he'll work wonders and miracles if you'll believe his word.
Amen.
Just take him at his word. You know, I'm reading this word. This is a written word. And it's just the same as Jesus talking to me right now when I read this written word. Now, he's a living word, but this is a written word. And it's powerful. Amen. It just has the power that it had when Jesus walked the shores of Galilee. It has the power, amen, that he had when he was crucified. This word is still powerful. And it sharpens a two-edged sword. It'll cut a preacher down to being living right. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I don't want to hear that.
Come on.
Glory to God. Hallelujah to God. Thank God for his word tonight. Thank God for heaven real, and heaven's going to be a wonderful place. The Bible talks about, I don't know what heaven really is going to be, but Jesus said, I'm going to go away and prepare a place for you, and if I go, I'll come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you will be also. I don't care if where it's at. Just as long as Jesus is there.
That's right.
I'm not looking for a mansion because he said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Oh, yeah, he did say in my Father's house are many mansions, but he didn't guarantee me a mansion. He said, in my Father's house are many mansions, but I'm going to prepare a place for you.
Amen.
Wherever Jesus is at is good enough for me.
Amen.
Praise God. I don't have to have a mansion. But I'm glad tonight to know that there's coming a time that heaven is going to be real to us.
Yes.
Right now, we know we have the blessed hope. The Bible calls this the word the blessed hope. That's a blessing we have, the blessed hope. You don't have no hope in anything else in this world.
That's right.
But in this Bible, this word of God, that's the only hope that you can find. Abraham, against hope, believed in hope. He went to the Word of God and got some hope. And then he started calling things that were not as though they were.
Amen.
Thank God you can do the same thing. Abraham, I started to preach while I go, Abraham's blessings is yours. You're blessed in the city. You're blessed in the field. You're the head, not the knees. You're not going crawling around. You're not the tail. You're the head. Amen. You're God. He said your storehouse is blessed. The fruit of your body is blessed. Your children, the fruit. Amen. He said you're blessed coming in. You're blessed when you go out. You're blessed when you lie down. You're blessed when you get up. Praise God. He said you're blessed, amen, and to be the head, not the tail. I'm above and not beneath. He said you're blessed to lend and not to borrow.
Glory!
He said, all these blessings are yours. All these blessings, and you keep my commandments. Thank God. He said, none of these diseases will come up on you that I put up on the Egyptian. Amen. God said, I'll heal you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Oh, yes. Praise God. We're a miracle. workers that will let God have his way in our life to help others. Amen. And I'm going to tell you, he's a good God, a merciful God, full of grace and full of truth.
Amen.
He'll never do anybody wrong.
No.
He's a loving God. I don't care how mean you think you are. I don't care how drunk you think you can get. Thank God he's bigger than all your problems. He's bigger than all your needs. He's God, and besides him, there is none other. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, you may not believe in shouting, but you better not get on the cloud with me, because I'm going out of here with a shout, and the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ is going to rise first, and we which are alive or remain will be changed in a moment. In the Lord in the clouds. Amen. And so shall we ever be with the Lord.
Yes.
Comfort one another. Thank God for that day.
Hallelujah.
Friends, it's so close to the coming of the Lord.
Yes.
We just believe that he could come before the presidential election. I believe that. Praise God.
Amen.
It's looking like that. It looks like right now that God is ready to split the eastern sky and come after his church that's made himself ready. Got on the wedding garment. Thank God. Where are we going to when we rapture out of here? We're going to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Woo! How are we going to have? At the marriage supper of the Lamb. Jesus said, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until I drink of the new in my Father's kingdom. Thank God he didn't say wine. He said the fruit of the vine. Until I drink of the new in my Father's kingdom. And I'm going to tell you something, friend. We're going to go to the wedding supper, and Jesus is going to marry the church. Glory to God. Now, Lord, I'll tell you, I feel like going up in the Word. Hallelujah.
Praise
you might God. Say that preacher is radical, fanatic. Well, I want to live up to that reputation. I'm trying my best. Praise God. I get radical, fanatic when the Holy Lord called me. I'd rather roll into heaven, stagger into hell.
Amen.
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 Somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Bless the Lord, O my soul. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it, in this day. I know somebody said, well, it's a hard old world. Amen. Yes, it is. But I'll tell you, if you get Jesus, it'll be a whole lot easier, friend.
Amen.
You got that blessed hope. You got that peace of mind. Amen. You can pillow your head, pillow at night and go to sleep as Jacob did many years ago. He pillowed his head on a stone, and he had a dream. He saw a ladder, and he saw angels ascending and descending, and he saw God at the top. And he woke up and he said, God was in this place and I knew it not. There's a lot of people going to wake up in church and find out that God's been there and they didn't know it, and they're lost and going to hell.
Amen.
You just can't be a good moral person and think you can get by. I've had people to say that, well, I don't drink and I don't smoke and I don't do this and I don't do that. You're just as lost as that Skid Row bum down there. He's just as lost as you are. And brother, I'm going to tell you, it's going to take salvation, because it's an individual plan of salvation. Not everyone that says, Lord, Lord, is going to heaven. That's all people going to be saying, Lord, Lord. But it's going to be too late.
That's right.
They're going to be like the five foolish virgins that knocked at the door.
Yes, amen.
Open up unto us.
Amen.
And he came back with the word and said, the door is now shut. Amen.
Amen.
And you can't get the door open once it's closed. Once he closes it, no man can open it. Once he opens it, no man can close it either.
Amen.
Thank God. Thank God for that word. Amen.
Yes.
Thank God. Even the five foolish virgins that they thought they were ready. A lot of people in churches think they're ready.
Yeah.
They're lukewarm, cold, and indifferent, backslidden, and they don't realize that they're going to hell. And you need to repent and get in and get out of here, run over.
God.
Because the church is going out of here very soon.
Amen.
So those five foolish virgins, they had a chance, but he told them, go buy it for your own self. Go buy you some oil for your own self, representing the Spirit of God. And the cry was made, behold, the bridegroom cometh, go you out to meet him. They all rose to trim their lamps, and the five foolish had no oil in their lamps. And they asked the wives to give us of your oil. You can't go on my salvation. You can't go on grandma's salvation or grandpa's, your family's salvation. You can't go because your grandmother belongs to the Church of God or the Baptist Church or whatever church. You can't go on their salvation. Salvation is a free gift, amen.
Amen.
It belongs to everyone that repents and calls upon the name of the Lord. They shall be saved. He that cometh to me, I'll no wise cast out, but he'll take you in.
Amen.
That's what he said.
Amen.
So the five foolish virgins was told to go buy for yourself oil. But while they went, the bridegroom came. The door was shut. And when this door was shut, here comes the five foolish knocking. Lord, open unto us. He said, I know you not.
Come on.
Boy, that'd be a sad word to hear.
Amen.
I know you not. They were hell bound.
Yes.
A lot of church folks look like that today. Millions of people go to church and they think you're just a good, normal person. And, well, I don't do this, I don't do that. Have you ever been born again? That's a key to the whole plan of salvation is born again, born from above. I didn't say you'll have a little water sprinkled on your being confirmed. I didn't say that. I said being born again. He told Nicodemus that Nicodemus was a ruler of the Jews. He was a smart man, but he came to Jesus and he wouldn't know what he had to do to be born again. A lot of people ask that question. What do you mean being born again? Born twice, amen. Born once, die twice. Born twice, die once. I carried around on me, and my former Mormon, he went around advertising the gospel and didn't know what it was. I said, that man said, born once, die twice. Born twice, die once, amen. He had and he went around advertising the gospel and didn't know what he was doing, amen. Praise the Lord. So the five foolish virgins, it was too late. The door was shut, and he wasn't going to open it for him. He'll not open it for you either, friend. He's giving you ample time. Get ready, get in, or get out, because the church is going out.
Yep.
I'm ready. I don't know about you. I've done made my reservations. I don't know about you, but I want to help you tonight if I can. You may be drinking. You may be sitting with beer in your hand. You may be laughing at me. Look at that crazy hillbilly preacher, call me whatever you want to. But I'll tell you, I love the Lord, and that's all that matters.
Amen.
And I want you tonight. I love you. Sinner, I love you. God loves you.
Amen.
I want to see you born again. I don't want to see you go to hell. I don't want to see nobody go to hell.
Nope.
Hell's going to be a miserable place, torment, where the fire and brimstone day and night, no rest day and night. Think about it.
Amen.
I want to see you saved, and I'm going to stop preaching right now, and I'm going to ask you to bow your head out in the land, wherever this gospel is going to you, where the message has touched your life, and you're under conviction, you don't know what to do, you're filled with fear right now, maybe you're trembling, maybe you're drinking beer, or maybe you're having yourself a good time, a big laugh out of my message. But I'm going to tell you something, God's going to have the last laugh.
Amen.
You may laugh at me, you may mock me, you may criticize me, but I'm going to tell you something, friend. I'm here to help you. I love you. God loves you. And I want you to see you saved. And we're going to pray. I'm going to ask you right now to bow your head, get on your knees if you can, and ask God to come into your heart. And he will. He that comes to me, and I'll no wise cast out. Whosoever will call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. That's a positive word. When you call on his name, as I pray with you, I want you to repeat the prayer after me. The sinner's prayer. Repeat it after me. Say, dear God in heaven, I'm a sinner. I'm lost, Lord. Oh God, come into my heart. My life has been miserable. And I've heard the message. I've heard the word of God. And I know it's Bible because I know the scripture. And Lord, will you forgive me? I'm a backslider. Will you come back into my heart and save me? I'm repenting of my sins. And I promise you, I'll live for you all the days of my life. And I'll follow you in water baptism. I'll follow you in forsaking not the assembling myself together more often as we see these days approaching. Come into my heart right now, Lord Jesus. And friends, if you prayed that simple prayer, it's so easy to get saved. A lot of people try to make a big story out of it, but I'm going to tell you, friend, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord with a sincere heart and a believing heart, that God will give you faith to get saved. You say, I ain't got no faith. He'll give you the measure of faith, and you can believe Him for it. Just believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, that He died for you and was crucified and rose from the dead. And the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, will wash you from all sins. Now, right now, lift your hands and praise God and say, I'm saved. I'm saved. I'm saved. Praise God. You feel it. You know it.
Amen.
The Spirit of God coming into your heart. You know it. And you feel like shout, go ahead and shout.
Amen.
Go ahead and lift holy hands unto God without laughing now. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm getting happy about ready to preach again, so I'm not going to. Brother Don, if you'll come on and give the people some information how they can get a hold of us. Please, please, please write to us and let us know if we're doing any good to help you. If you'll do that, we'll write you back. We'll do everything we can to help you. Just send us a few words if you want to. Call us on the somehow. Don's going to give you the information on how to get a hold of us. All right, God bless you.
You know, when you write to us, when you fill out the contact form, we'll pray right along with you. And your prayer will go on our prayer table over here. Each time one comes in, we print it out and we take it. And each time we pray.
Yes, amen.
For the prayers that come in.
All right.
Praise the Lord.
Lord, we still pray for these prayers and the prayer requests that still believe that you're able to save them, redeem them, heal them, give them hope, Lord, and comfort their heart. Let them know that we're praying, we're believing God to grant every prayer or petition that comes to us in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, we thank you for it. They have faith to write, we got faith to believe in Jesus' name for them to be healed, to be saved and sanctified, and baptize those that need the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Baptize them with the evidence of speaking in other tongues as the Spirit of God gives others in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Lord, I'm just about ready to have myself another spasm here. Go ahead, Brother Don.
All right.
Praise
There's
the Lord.
Three ways that you can contact us. First, you can write us a letter here at Trenton Church of God. Put Attention Pastor on it. Our address is 35 Rorick Street.
Yes.
That's Trenton, Michigan, 48183. Again, that address is 35 Rorick. That's R-O-E-H-R-I-G. Trenton, Michigan, 48183. The second way that you can contact us, send me an email at donalddrews50@gmail.com. That's all small letters, all one word. donalddrews50@gmail.com. The third way is to visit us on the web. Take a look at our website. There, you can see what we're about. You can look at each and every person there in that. You can see past sermons. They're all listed there. They're listed by month. Just click on the month, and you will be able to bring up four sermons, whichever sermon you can remember that you want to hear, click on it. You can hear it again. You can hear it over and over. On our website, you can see upcoming events. Remember, that's TrentonChurchGod.com. You can see different upcoming events. You can also contact us there. Do we have any contact form? Fill out every single box. Don't miss a box.
Amen.
Then hit submit. There, you can also see, you can order tapes. You can also pay your tithes. It takes you to a very secure website. When you click on donate, it'll take you, it'll ask you to your name, your address. It'll ask you your email address. It'll ask you the amount that you want to donate or pay your tithes and that. And when you put in all your information, I ask you, don't put it up. There's a little helpful thing on the bottom of the give program and the take program. There are instructions that'll help you out. Follow those. But remember to fill out each and every box and stuff. There, when you pay your tithes, what we want, this church wants to remind each and every one of you, if you have a home church, you are to pay your tithes there. That pastor and that church could use your tithe if you have a home church. If you want to become a member of this church here, then you can pay your tithes here. And we'd love to have you. If you don't have a home church, come be a part of us. We have three different services. We have a service on Sunday morning at 10:30, Sunday evening at 6 o'clock, and Wednesday at 7. We also have a prayer cloth ministry here. Here, we'll anoint these prayer cloths, and we'll send it to you. All it takes is a letter, an email,
yes,
or fill out the contact form. Ask for one of these prayer cloths. We'll anoint it with oil, we'll pray over it, and we'll put it in an envelope and send it to you. There's three crosses on a hill. There's a Bible verse on here from Acts 19, verse 11 and 12, and it said, God wrought special miracles by the hands of Paul, so that from his body were brought unto the sick handkerchiefs or aprons, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirits,
amen, yes,
went out of them. It's even got some telephone numbers down here and our name on it and stuff. So there's a lot of information right there. Just remember, when you can pay your tithe online, you can give the church a gift.
Amen.
You can also order tapes from our tape ministry. And that. We have tapes from our revival. We have four tapes here for 10. Generally, there are 3 for $10, but we went 4 days, and we'll give you 4 CDs for $10 plus $4 shipping. There you have it. So, come Sunday morning, Sunday evening, and Wednesday. Be a blessing and get a blessing. Amen. Amen.
All right. God bless everyone. Until next Sunday, we'll be praying for you and trusting that God has done something great for you. God bless you.
Amen.